Dear students, a warm welcome in the series of online lecture of microbiology. This is paper Molecular Biology and Genetic Engineering, and today we are going to discuss on the topic History of Genetic Engineering. History of Genetic Engineering. Before going to the history of genetic engineering, first of all, let's learn what is genetic engineering. Genetic engineering is the direct manipulation of an organism's genes using biotechnology. This is genetic engineering. It is a set of technologies used to change the genetic makeup of cells, including transfer of genes within and across species boundaries to produce improved or novel organisms. Genetic modification or manipulation technology implies precision engineering being applied to DNA molecules, therefore called as genetic engineering. The term genetic engineering was first coined by Jack Williamson in his science fiction novel. Genetic engineering is based on gene cloning technology, that is, making recombinant DNA molecules that can replicate in host cells, which is then reproduced to make its clone. This is an overview of gene cloning procedure. The research on genetic engineering is centered on in vitro joining of DNA fragments of different origins. By the mediation of some highly specific enzyme to produce chimeric or recombinant DNA. This is chimeric or recombinant DNA, which is then introduced into appropriate host, wherein it multiplies. Thus, the genetic engineering is also called recombinant DNA technology. Recombinant DNA technology implies the new combination of DNA molecules can be made, that is, recombinant DNA molecules. It is perhaps the finest output from the brains of biologists who have been interested in tailoring and manipulating heredity to the best of man's advantage. The onset of this new revolutionary technology of genetic engineering took place at Massachusetts Institute of Technology, USA, when H.G. Khurana, a brain of Indian origin, along with his colleagues in 1972, reported total synthesis of an artificial gene, namely tyrosine, tRNA gene, with the potential for functioning within a living cell. Genetic engineering based on recombination was first pioneered in 1973 by American biochemist Stanley N. Cohen and Herbert W. Boyer, who were among the first to cut the DNA into fragments, rejoin different fragments, and insert new genes into E. coli bacteria, which then reproduced. Since 1976, the technology has been commercialized, with many companies producing and selling genetically modified food and medicine. Here is a brief history of genetic modification. Genetic modification dates back to ancient times when humans influenced genetics by selectively breeding organisms. When repeated over several generations, this process leads to dramatic change in the species. Prehistoric times to 19th century. Some naturalists and farmers begin to recognize hybrids, that is, plants produced through natural breeding between related varieties of plants. Modification to produce desired traits in plants, animals, and microbes used for food began about 10,000 years ago. These changes, along with natural evolutionary changes, have resulted in common food species that are now genetically different from their ancestors. Advantageous outcomes of these genetic modifications include increased food production, reliability, and yields, enhanced taste and nutritional value, and decreased losses due to various biotic and abiotic stresses, such as fungal and bacterial pathogens. These objectives continue to motivate modern breeders and food scientists who have designed newer genetic modification methods for identifying, selecting, and analyzing individual organisms that possesses genetically enhanced features. In 1900s, major breakthroughs in genetic engineering are, first is genetic inheritance, that was first discovered by Gregor Mendel in 1865. This is the picture of Gregor Mendel. Following experiments of crossing peas that led to the foundation of modern genetics. In 1869, nucleic acids was isolated by Friedrich Mischier. In 1902, Walter Sutton and Theodore Boveri proposed that inheritance is due to chromosomes. The term genetics was coined by William Bateson in 1905. In 1910, Thomas Morgan demonstrated that the chromosomes carry the genes. In 1948, Barbara McClintock discovered transposons. In 1940s and 50s, Frederick Griffith experiment, that is transformation experiment, and Martha Chase and Alfred Hershey's blender experiment proved that DNA is heredity material and carries genetic information. This is Griffith's experiment of transformation, and this represents Martha Chase and Alfred Hershey's experiment, blender's experiment, to prove that DNA is genetic material and carries genetic information. Now, some facts and discoveries in modern genetic engineering. Genetic engineering date back to 1953 when James Watson, Francis Crick, and Morris Wilkin first developed a 3D model of DNA, that is, three-dimensional double helix structure of DNA. Their discovery opened the door to understanding what we know today about genes and gene traits in organisms such as plants, animals, humans, and microorganisms. The three shared the 1962 Nobel Prize for Physiology and Medicine. James Watson and Francis Crick showed that the DNA molecule has a double helix structure. In 1961, Sidney Brenner, Francois Jacob, and Matthew Michelson discovered messenger RNA. In 1966, Marshall Nirenberg and Har Gobind Khurana developed genetic code. In 1969, Stewart Lynn and Werner Erber discovered restriction enzymes in Escherichia coli. In 1972, Paul Burke created the first recombinant DNA molecules by combining DNA from the monkey virus SV40 with that of phage virus. In 1973, Herbert Bouyer and Stanley Cohen created the first successful recombinant DNA organism, that is, transgenic organism, by inserting antibiotic-resistant genes into the plasmid of an E. coli bacterium. Genetic engineering or genetically modified organism has made great advances in technology and research, starting with the discovery of DNA cloning by Cohen and Bouyer in 1973 that led to the first genetically modified organism, that is transgenic mouse, in 1980. In 1976, the first genetic engineering company was founded by Herbert Bouyer and Robert Swanson. Since 1976, commercialization of genetically modified food, feedstock and medicine, insulin, growth hormone, erythropoietin, factor 9, interferon, interleukins, tissue plasminogen activator has been started. Other are vaccine production, glowfish to help detect environmental pollution, flavored tomato, golden rice, GM potato, soybean, and BT corn, etc. In 1977, DNA sequencing method by Frederick Sanger was developed. In 1980, the US Supreme Court approved that genetically altered life forms can be patented. The decision allows the Exxon Oil Company to patent an oil-eating microorganism. In 1982, the US Food and Drug Administration approved the first genetically engineered drug, Genetics Humulin, a form of human humulin produced by bacteria. This was the first consumer product developed through modern bioengineering. The first genetically engineered plant was tobacco, reported in 1983 by Michael Bevan, Richard B. Flavel, and Mary Dell Clinton at Washington University in St. Louis and Andrew Binns from the University of Pennsylvania. Through tissue culture techniques, a single tobacco cell was selected that contained the gene and a new plant grown from it. In 1983, polymerase chain reaction by Carl Mullis was developed. In 1986, the first field tests of genetically engineered plants, that is of tobacco, were conducted in Belgium. In 1987, the first field tests of genetically engineered crops, that is of tobacco and tomato, were conducted in United States. In between 1990s and 2010, the main focus was on the large-scale genetics projects and entire genome sequencing. Since the 1990s, gene therapy in clinical traits to treat diseases and conditions such as AIDS, cystic fibrosis, cancer, and cholesterol, etc. was developed. The first genetic engineered food product, that is chymosin, a substitute for essential enzyme used to make cheese, came on market in 1990. It is now used to make more than half of all cheese produced in the US. In 1992, transgenic tomato engineered to remain firm for a longer period of time. It was approved for commercial production by US Department of Agriculture. In 1992 again, the FDA declares the genetically engineered foods are not inherently dangerous and do not require special regulation. The first genetically engineered animal drug was a hormone manufactured by Monsanto crop called recombinant bovine growth hormone, It was approved in 1993 by the FDA. It is injected into dairy cows to increase their milk production. According to Monsanto, 30% of US dairy cows receive this hormone. The first whole genetically engineered food, the flavored tomato, was approved in 1994. It was manufactured by a company called Calgene, which developed a tomato to have 90% longer vine and shelf life to give consumers a tomato that lasted longer and tasted more like a wine ripened one. The product proved too costly to produce and was pulled from the market. In 1994, the European Union's first genetically engineered crop tobacco was approved in France. The first field trials of genetically engineered plants occurred in France and the USA in 1996. Tobacco plants were engineered to be resistant to herbicides. In 1997, world's first mammalian clone, Dolly, was developed from a non-reproductive cell of an adult animal through cloning by nuclear transplantation. In 2000, International Biosafety Protocol was approved by 130 countries at the Convention on Biological Diversity in Montreal, Canada. The protocol agreed upon labeling of genetically engineered crops, but still needs to be ratified by 50 nations before it goes into effect. In 2003, the whole genome of human was sequenced. Now, the latest discoveries in the field of genetic engineering are RNA interference and other gene silencing technologies, gene and genome editing methodologies, other clinical translations such as modified immune cells and stem cells. Following the elucidation of the DNA structure and the genetic code, it became clear that many biological secrets were hidden in the sequence of bases in DNA. Technical and biological discoveries in 1970s led to a new era of DNA analysis and manipulation. Key among these was the discovery of two enzymes that made DNA cloning possible. Cloning in this sense refers to the isolation and amplification of defined pieces of DNA. One enzyme type called restriction enzyme cut the DNA from any organism at specific sequences of a few nucleotides, generating a reproducible set of fragments. Restriction enzymes occur naturally in many bacteria, where they serve as defense mechanisms against bacteriophage infection by cutting the bacteriophage's genome upon its entry into the cell. The other enzyme type called DNA ligases can covalently join DNA fragments at their termini that have been created by restriction enzymes. Thus, ligases can insert DNA restriction fragments into replicating DNA molecules such as plasmids, resulting in recombinant DNA molecules. The recombinant DNA molecules can then be introduced into appropriate host cells, most often bacterial cells. All descendants from such a single cell, called a clone, carry the same recombinant DNA molecule. Once a clone of cells bearing a desired segment of DNA has been isolated, unlimited quantities of this DNA sequence can be prepared. Furthermore, in case the DNA fragment contains protein coding genes, the recombinant DNA molecule introduced into a suitable host can direct the expression of these genes, resulting in the production of proteins within the host. These developments, DNA cloning and the production of recombinant proteins, were major breakthroughs in molecular biology and genetic engineering, and set the stage for modern biological research. These were the history of genetic engineering and major discoveries in the field. These are the references that has been cited. Thank you.